Hello, YouTubers. It's Championdjk coming at you yet again with another weekly update video, and I hauler in this week again. Well, first of all, I got a lot of mail. Heavy Metal 164 sent me a box, another one, and let's see here. I got a bunch of Auto World in the mail mostly, and I found a couple things, and I'm just going to show it all to you. So, first of all, I did find a couple of these Nissan Skylines. I found two with this silver card. I think originally they were all being found with a silver car and blue card. I don't really care too much about it, but it is a difference, and I decided to pick one up. I already have one of these loose. Later on in the second half of the video, we're going to go ahead and compare that, the casting, to this Tomica Limited Vintage that I got from Travis, Heavy Metal 164. Thank you, buddy. So pretty cool. We'll take a close look at that car in a minute. We'll also take a close look at this Merc, this Kyosho. I'll take that off the base. We'll take a close look at that. Of course, Travis also sent me this Hummer. And this Hummer is a White Lightning. I'm going to go ahead and free the piece on that. He wants me to put headlights in this thing and have one that's headlights for myself. You know, I just might do that, and I just might not. I might just leave this loose, because it is a really cool casting as is without me drilling it apart and putting work into it. But really, really cool to have the White Lightning version of this. Very awesome, Travis. Thank you very much. I found at Hobby Lobby one of these Gone Fishing things. They were $15.99, and of course 40% off of that, so what it ended up being, somewhere with tax, like $10.50 or something. Not too bad. I'm not going to open it. I do have, it's not the first time Johnny Lightning's done boats before, in case you didn't know. This is the Bassin USA series. Pretty cool. This boat, when did this come out? I should have looked at that before. I'm not sure. But anyway, there's that. I found that a while back, and now I got that. That's pretty cool. So the modern one. This one is the Chevy truck with boat and trailer. It is the weathered looking one. So there's that. Pretty neat. So I found that at Hobby Lobby. I guess that's the only place that those are going to be showing up, is Hobby Lobby. So that's where you'll have to go to find them. Let's see here. Set that down here. My buddy Crazy Todd helped me find a bunch of Auto World this week. A bunch of this series. It's going to be 2017 Release 1 Set A, which now I have all of these thanks to my buddy Crazy Todd and thanks to my buddy Suresh for finding the ones I needed. So I got this whole set, that set complete, and duplicates of the one I wanted duplicates of. I was able to get 2017 Release 1 Set B, and I got that from a little place, Max Little Cars, and shout out to Johnny Lightning Grand National on Instagram, who tipped me off to these guys having it for a pretty good price and having one set left, so I went and grabbed it. So I got that set. That's pretty cool. We'll take a closer look at the whole set in the second half of the video. Then I also got Release 5 Set D in the mail as well this week. In addition to the set that I already unboxed in a previous video this week, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 sets of Auto World. So 24 cars. So I kind of went crazy this week. I have two of these, so of course I'm going to crack one of these Firebirds, and that is sweet. Very, very awesome. We'll take a close look at that in the second half of the video, and let's see here, what else did I get? Oh, and the other stuff I got basically was from my buddy Crazy Todd, who found me this Datsun, Nissan, or it is listed as a Datsun 280ZX. Johnny Lightning, that's pretty cool. I've been looking for that one. I want the other color as well. He found that for me actually today. He also found me the Nerds BW bus, which I'm just going to open this guy up, hopefully. Take a look at that. That is pretty cool. Nerds are great. So, add that to the VW bus collection. And then he got me a bug. That's pretty cool. A Matchbox bug I did not have. So go ahead and open that guy up. Read the piece on that one. So that'll go in the Beetle collection. It's a nice little red Beetle. Pretty sweet. And then the best thing he did was he RAOK'd me a Pontiac Vibe GT. This is a Matchbox Collectibles Showcase Series. Pontiac Vibe GT. So it's a Matchbox and it is in a clamshell. Pretty cool. The reason why this is so cool to me is because this is the car I drive. I drive a Pontiac Vibe GT. I think it's a one body style newer than this, but this is the closest thing in 1 to 64 scale that you can get to my real vehicle that I actually, my everyday driver. So, there that is. That's pretty cool. So that's pretty much all I found. We're going to go ahead and flip the camera around. We'll take a close look at all the Auto World sets, kind of go through them quickly. And then we'll take a look at this Tomica. And yeah, see you in a second. Okay, let's take a quick look at a couple of things before we get into the Auto World section of this video, which we are going to get into pretty heavy here. At least I got a lot to show. So first of all, this is the Matchbox Vibe, Pontiac Vibe GT, which is very close to my actual vehicle that I drive every day. I've got a Pontiac Vibe GT. It's just a newer body style than this is. I believe mine's a 2009, I think. Yeah. This one is a... I'm not really sure what it is. But pretty cool. Nice little piece of die-cast. You got rubber tires with tread. Plastic base, but we got details all the way around. Really nice premium Matchbox. So, love this thing. That's very awesome. Thank you very much, Todd, for giving that to me. And then, of course, Todd found me this bus. Just a quick look at the Nerds. VW bus. Pretty cool. It's a bus nonetheless. It'll go into my little collection of VW buses, so it fits in nicely with that. And that'll be nice. And then we got this Beetle, this red Beetle. This is pretty sweet. Todd just gave this to me too, and I appreciate it. It's a Matchbox Beetle variation that I did not have, so that will be welcome in the VW collection. All right, let's take a quick look at the Kyosho that Travis sent me. These things are really nice. They're metal body, plastic base. The base has got some sort of detail on it. A lot of the Kyosho bases are pretty plain. A lot of them don't have a lot of detail. This one does. And it's got rubber tires with tread. We got inserts for headlamps, inserts for taillights, silver trim painted on it. Very nice. Very nice little car. So I'll definitely probably pick up a few more Kyoshos for the collection. Because, you know, it's just cool to broaden. It's a premium die-cast brand, and it makes cars that, you know, you can't get in some other brands. So, really, really neat. And this is one of the few Kyoshos I have in my collection. I have two other ones that I've gotten from Lamar Fashion, and now I have this third one. So, I only have three Kyoshos in the collection right now, but that collection probably will grow in the near future here. Then let's take a quick look at this Hummer. This is the White Lightning. And the way you tell this is a White Lightning is because of the white base and the white interior. Of course, nowadays, they make everything white on the car. White tires, pearl white body, and all that. They make it really obvious to see it's a White Lightning. Johnny Lightning's done a lot of different things with their chases. And some of them were, you know, a little more subtle, like this white base. So, it is a White Lightning, though. That is pretty cool. This casting is really neat. It's heavy. It's a really cool casting, so thank you, Travis, for hooking me up with that. I had fun putting the lights in the one for you. I'm probably not going to put lights in this one. And then here's that sweet Skyline. This thing is awesome. Tomica Limited Vintage. We've got metal body. We have a metal base. The base is somewhat detailed. The detail, though, on the exterior of this car is exquisite. We've got plastic bumpers, we've got inserts for headlamps,
inserts for tail lamps. The steering wheel is actually like painted like a wood color. I don't know if you can see in there, you probably can't. But this thing is awesome. It's got rubber tires, of course, and it's got suspension. Tomica has suspension. That is a really cool feature to the vehicle. It just makes it, I don't know, feel really neat compared to other diecasts, especially when it rolls. I mean, it does roll a little bit smoother. This one doesn't roll all that well, but, I mean, it does roll. So, pretty cool. This is really neat. And then here's just the Matchbox one, just for a size comparison. This is the closest thing you can get in a Matchbox, but this thing is a buck. And for a dollar, I'd say you really get your money's worth with this one. It's really nice. As most of the Matchbox license stuff is now, is just so nice. And for a dollar, I mean, come on. That's a sweet car for a buck. So, of course, this is cost a pretty penny, quite more than that. So, pretty neat. There's your two Skylines. And I'm going to pause the video quick, and we'll get into some Auto World. All right, let's take a look at some Auto World, and let's start with Premium Release 5. So here's Premium Release 5 Set D, as in dog. So here we go. We got the 66 Chevy Impala. Of course, in Release 5, there are four color variation releases. There is A, B, C, and D. This is the D release, so is the latest release. So here's your Impala in this kind of brown, metal flake brown color. Looks really nice, actually, in this color. Very cool. Here is your 1958 Plymouth Fury in kind of a baby blue with gold trim. Pretty cool. The next up we got, this is a really awesome casting. This is your 64 Ford Galaxy 500 XL. This thing is really nice. This is kind of like a silver. I wish I knew the names of these colors. I should learn them. But really, really cool. Nice color. Very nice car. Very nice casting. And there's that one. Then we have the Dodge Dart Swinger. This is kind of in a metallic turquoise, is maybe what you'd call it. But it's probably the best color of this car in out of these releases, definitely. I think this one is pretty good looking. So there's that. And then we got the Oldsmobile 442. These cars got shipped to me from 3000toys.com, which is where I got that case, that release 3B. And we're going to open this one because it's falling apart. It's falling off the blister already. There's your gold old 442. Which is probably the coolest color that this one is in the release, out of the releases. There's your motor. That's detailed up nicely. It's shiny in there. That looks really cool, actually. This is a nice casting. Got a nice bit of weight to it, as all Auto World do. There's your detailed metal base. Very, very nice. Do that, and then of course the best one of the bunch is this Firebird that I already cracked. Definitely my favorite. Open the hood. Of course, it's got detailed motor detail. Pretty awesome. There's your base. Just very, very nice. I love Auto World. I love how heavy they are. I just like how they feel. You have to open a few of them up to really appreciate them. Even if you're a carded collector, open one up and you'll want to buy more carded ones. Just because they are awesome. And then you'll fight with yourself on, you know, trying not to open these things. Because they're just so nice. And they photograph, obviously, much nicer out of the package. So there's that. So that is your Release 5 Set D. Okay. Next up, we're going to take a look at 2017. This is Release 1 Set A. And here's your Pontiac Firebird. In an earlier video I showed, when I originally found this car, I found it with the wrong wheel on the back. And I still don't know what the deal is with that, how many of these maybe there are, if it's just a one-off or what. But that is weird. It's got the wrong wheel on this. And it's not even a wheel from another car in this release. The only wheel that it actually matches is this one here. And actually, you know what, now that I look at it, it doesn't even match that one. So never mind.
It doesn't match any of these. It matches close to the Impala we're going to look at, but it's got a different tire on it. So, I don't know. That's really goofy to have that one other wheel. So, if anybody knows any information about that, if this is like a known variation, or is it just an error, or what it is, but it's pretty cool. This is how it's supposed to look, though. So, love this casting. This casting's been out a couple of times in two other releases before, so it's in four different colors already. And but these ones, they kind of went a different direction and made it look, I don't know, almost sportier like this. I don't know. It just looks a little different than the other release. Maybe sometime I'll do a variation Sunday on it, but it's pretty cool. So there's that. That's one car in the release. And then we got the, and then I'll show you, actually, let's take a look at both of these series at once. So here is your set B, 2017. Release one, set B. So here's the B color of the Firebird. Maybe that's a better way to look at them, so you can see both colors side by side. So there's that. Oh, and then, of course, I also have one of the silver ones loose. So there's that guy. You can get a closer look at that. Go ahead and open up the hood. Detailed motor. The motor looks sweet in there, actually. It looks a lot more detailed, I think, than the other release of this vehicle. So that is pretty awesome. There's the rear. Really, really cool. So there's that car, and here it is in the two colors I have carded. So I have to get one more of these to have loose yet. So that's pretty awesome. And then let's take a look at the Ford Country Squire. You got it in a, I guess that's a metallic turquoise. I don't know what color that is. So this is your set A, and then this is your set B. Maybe we should do it like this so it makes sense left to right. In black. I definitely prefer it in the black. Take a closer look at that over that other color. But this is a really neat casting. This one actually has been out in one other release so far, I believe. No, two other releases maybe. Or maybe just one. I don't know. I can't remember. But it's, I think it's only been out one other release, so two other colors you can get of this. And, of course, they'll probably do a set C and a set D for these. Actually, I know they will. So there's going to be two more colors of that casting to collect if you like that one. Next up, we got the Pontiac Grand Prix. And this is in the set A color. And then here is your set B color. There's been a lot of talk about not being able to tell if this is an Ultra Red or not. Shoot, I wish I had an Ultra Red. Actually, hang on one second. Sorry about that, but here's an Ultra Red of that casting. So here's what an Ultra Red color looks like. Okay, this isn't a different, this is actually release 4, but of course the Ultra Red color is going to look similar. So here's Ultra Red of this casting, and here is this casting in that, in the red or maroonish color. It's a dark red color. So, see the difference? There it is. So there's that, and then here it is in like a kind of a, man, these colors are hard to describe. This is kind of like a champagne-ish with a green tint to it, a bit of it. Maybe I'm just not good at seeing color, but they're just hard to describe. I don't know the actual names of the colors. So there is that, and let's see here. We got three more castings to look at. Here is your Impala. This is your set A in blue, and then your set B in this cream color. Definitely prefer it in this blue color, and I had to get one loose. So I got one cracked open. Here's your rear. There's the front. Here's the side. This one has a little paint flaw right there, which irks me a little bit, but I have another one. So if it really bothers me, I can open that other one. So then here's the detail on the engine. Pretty sweet. And just a really cool car. So I really like this one. This is one of the standouts in the release for sure. So that is pretty cool. And then here, of course, it is in the two colors. Again, did I mention these are limited to 1672? Yeah, these cases are limited to 1672. So if that's true, they're going to be kind of hard to get. They're going to hit your Walmart probably once, and they're going to be gone.
which they just hit my Walmart, so this the release, the set A did anyway. Here is the purple, or plum crazy probably, 1971 Dodge Challenger RT. This is a sweet casting. This is your set A. Here's a set B in Sublime Green. These ones are easy to tell you what color it is. So pretty awesome. It's also cool that there's a variation at the top, so that you know you got a white top and a black top. So that's pretty cool too. But very cool. So there's that release. And then probably a lot of the, everybody's favorite probably is going to be this one right here. This 63 Dodge Polara Max Wedge 426, and this thing is just very nice looking. Just a really nice looking car. And then here is your set B in white, which it looks pretty good in white too. But that black, man, that just looks pretty slick. And then of course I had to have one of the black ones loose because these hit my Walmart. So aside from ordering these, I was able to get some more. And here this thing is. This thing is just awesome. I love how the hood actually has an intake in it. Like, it's got holes in it. Ooh, I'm trying to open this hood here. Sorry. But yeah, you can see the motor through the holes in the hood. There's the motor in there. This thing is just sweet. It actually rolls really well as well. It's kind of the same thing they did with the Galaxy in set A and set B. They had a white one and a black one. And I should have got the black one out before starting this video to show you them side by side, because I bet you they look pretty cool next to each other. Maybe I'll do a shot for Instagram for that. So, and that's it. So I showed you all six cars from three releases of Auto World. And then we also had that video earlier in the week of release 3 set B, which is an older release. Pretty fair to say I am addicted to buying Auto World. If I see it in the stores, it's going to be difficult for me to leave them behind. And I don't know if it's just because they're so limited or because I just love them so much. And and I will buy all these cars in every single color that they come out with until I get sick of it. I want a carny case, and I want to get one that has the angled cars, 148 count, and just eventually crack all my Auto World and put them in that case. And that's going to just, that'll be the bee's knees for me. So anyway, that is going to be it for this week. Thank you guys for sticking around. Sorry for shoving Auto World down your throat so much over the past couple weeks, but I'm head over heels. But hopefully we'll be able to show you a variety of stuff continuing in the next few weeks, and hopefully maybe some customs as well. So have a great day. Thank you very much.